Nikocado Avocado, stop being so little whiny douchebag. 'Tis because this world is a dangerous place, not because of the people that being evil, but because of the people that do nothing to change the evil. Nobody stands up. That's what the world makes a dangerous place. It's because of people like you.
Can't even talk. You're a terrible person just because you don't eat what I eat.
Veganism is not a diet. Veganism is an ethical lifestyle which includes respect for any living being there will be. Veganism acknowledges the intrinsic limitancy of all life. It don't recognize any higher acceptability in suffering between sentient beings. It is not more acceptable to kill creatures with primitive nervous systems than though with highly evolved nervous systems. The value of life of which possess here is the same, no matter if it being a cow, a chicken, a crayfish, or a child.
I don't know, I'm confused.
Maybe you have to eat a little bit more healthy. A lot of junk food can actually give you mental illness. And I've seen that you eat a lot of junk food on your channel. Maybe so, that's the problem. Maybe get a little bit more vitamins and minerals, which actually all come from plant-based sources. There is no single nutrient that you not can find in the plant kingdom. Absolutely no one. Even vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is actually one bacteria that normally live in the intestines and mouth of healthy people. But the majority of people eat a lot of unhealthy stuff that can decrease the amount of vitamins that have been absorbed by the body and can destroy that system that make vitamin B12 in your body. So maybe the reason that you don't get enough vitamins and minerals in the first place is because you eat too little nutritional based food. You mainly eat highly processed, high fat food. So eat more carbohydrate rich food with a lot of nutrients. There've been a lot of channels that can show you what you can eat, and make no excuse.
I went out and I bought sardines. I have never even had sardines in my entire life. I won't even focus. That's sardines. Now, it's basically Sebastian from The Little Mermaid. I don't want to eat flounder, the fish.
Ew. Avocado boy. Promoting child labor. From Thailand, there comes the most amount of sardines and tuna, and most of them also being involved in child labor, just like in this article. And fish being also pretty important beings. There's a lot myths about that fish being stupid and have a short memory track. Some fish have actually a memory track from months and some even years. It's an analogy to help you sympathize with fish. Imagine that you walk for a round, and you, after walking for a round, you become hungry, and you see an apple tree on the side of the road. You go to the apple tree and take with your hand one of the apples out of the apple tree, and then one metal object become out of the sky and cut in your hand. It put you to an atmosphere where you don't can breathe. We breathe, kill and drown animals, fish animals, in the same way that we drown in there. And if you're starting to eat fish because of Omaha tree, then I say you, the highest source of Omega 3 is actually flax seeds and walnuts, and even bananas have small amounts of EPA as well. And actually the amount that you need is a little bit overestimated, because it's for meat eaters. What Omega 3 or EPA actually do is thinning the blood. But what it do? Make the blood less thick. So let us stop with believing propaganda from the meat industry that so desperately try to convince you to eat their products, just like any other business want to do. And cut on the propaganda and become again vegan, and delete all your horrible videos where you promote the eating of corpses and the imitation of Shane Dawson. And a Shane Dawson, let's see this video. See, stop being a douchebag.
Hi guys, it's me. It's me, Nikocado Avocado. I'm here at my mukbang table where I eat every single day for you guys. And speaking of food, I'm here trying to enjoy some lentils with potatoes. Low salt, high vegetables, healthy, whole foods, right? I don't know. Doesn't do it for me anymore.
Nikocado, I say you now, stop being a miserable fool. If one person know that there been a lot of things that you can eat as a vegan, and that you don't eat only that stuff, you can eat beans, lentils, legumes, tofu. There be a lot of different stuff you can eat as a vegan. You don't have to eat only celeries and all the things, and I know where you do it. And it makes me very furious. Yes, that's the word. It is true. Money is the root of all evil. Is it truly all of that word? Should that you get some money out of it? So that other living beings have to suffer for your laziness?
I've been debating in my head for the last hour, basically, about making this video. This still has crumbs from my mukbang, but whatever. Because I'm scared and I'm confused. And I don't want people to hate me because of what I eat. Some enlightenment on your part. It goes for anything, whether animals are involved or not. That mindset is very common among vegans. I've been there myself. I've been in those shoes where I basically pushed my whole family away, pushed away my friendships, my coworkers, because they didn't eat what I ate, and I somehow felt like I was superior.
Sorry, Nikocado, vegans being more superior than meat eaters, the dairy eaters, the vegetarians, because Be you serious? Think you also that you be that somebody that rape is equal to somebody that not rape? In the same way, in this way, let me explain it a little bit. Somebody that not rape, torture, and abuse, and murder, or pay for murder of animals, is better than somebody that do rape, torture, and abuse other animals. Just like somebody that is not a rapist is better than somebody that rape. Just like that somebody that's not a murderer is better than somebody that murders. Or pay for some murder. Or pay for somebody to rape. Can you understand it? Moral standpoints make you a better person than somebody that have no moral standpoints. Or think you that the Nazis been equal to the well, as the Jews. And that's it is now time to tell you actually what the brilliant solution of Gandhi of the Holocaust was. His solution was that all Jews have to commit suicide to raise the consciousness of the planet. If you truly say that the victims have to be treated the same as the victimizers, you be for that solution. And that's the same idiotic philosophy. That's so a lot of people have this time. Sometimes, and I'm proud to say this, sometimes you have to put people away. If they not want to listen, if they still want to support violence or evil rituals, want you to hang around with a rapist? Imagine that your father is a rapist, or your mother is a rapist, or your sister or your brother. Let's just say something weird like that. But imagine that. Want you to hang around with them anymore? Or want you to forgive them because they've been in the family? I talked sometimes with my meat-eating family members. But I also despise them for what they do to other animal species. Sorry. But if you being responsible in this age, you have to take responsibility. Make a plea and move forward. There is no actually excuse to veganism. Make a plea and move forward. And don't be basic, hypocritical douchebag. And go vegan. The animals there don't care about your excuses. They only care about what you do. And what you not do.
And I understand the brutality and how awful. You guys, you don't understand. I have seen all the videos. I have spent probably a month and time's worth watching those graphic PETA videos and undercover talks and direct action everywhere and all of these things that show you, oh, how this is made, factory farming, blah, blah, blah. And it's terrible. It's terrible. It rips your heart out and makes it go, whoop, I don't want to support that ever again.
And if you have seen all the videos, why you go back to that? If you honestly have seen the videos, if you have seen Cowspiracy, if you have seen Earthlings, if you have seen all the documentaries, why in hell's name you go back to eating animal products? If you don't been aware of that, yes, I can understand. I can forgive you what you do. But if you be truly aware of what you, what the animals go to, I have no respect for you anymore. You can be so nice, totally a friendly talking if you want, but it don't make any sense. Only thing that matters is your actions. And then, veganism is not a diet. Veganism is an ethical lifestyle. And if the way you eat don't work, there been a trillion different styles of veganism that you can try. You can eat raw, you can eat high star solution, you can eat raw tofu, you can eat raw fat, you can eat just like fully raw carnitina, you can eat a lot of different styles actually. You don't only have junk food vegan, what you have to have done for a long time. Seen on your chickman face. Talk to that. I'd be very disappointed. You.
But how much does philosophy or ideology, how much does it weigh over biology, over the fact that we're omnivores?
How much philosophy, what you think from science? The human body is for 100% herbivore. Not carnivore, not omnivore. From the side-to-side molars of our lower jaw like this, to the fact that we sweat to our pores to cool ourselves down, to the fact that our intestinal tract is around something like 7 to 12 times the length of our torso, to the fact that we have amylase in our saliva to digest starch. To the fact that we don't can see well in the dark, that we don't can change scroll, to the fact that we don't can digest meat so well, and that actually that meat stay around something like a whole week in our intestinal tract because we have not the optimal enzymes to digest it, and that the fact that only herbivore animals can get heart attacks and strokes from eating high amount of animal fat. We've been 100% herbivore. I've linked in the description, and so if I do most of the time a link where you can see actually what we're talking about. This is a lie of the meat, dairy and egg industry that have already long ago been break down. Yes, humans eat animal products, the most of humans, but it don't make humans optimal to digest and eat animal products. If a horse have only one stomach, if a horse eat a hamburger, become the horse then omnivore or carnivore? Please get a straight point, people. The absurdity that comes out some people's mouth, it is stunning to me.
No matter how you look at it, we were not designed.
If you believe in God, more than in this video, look not further than the Garden of Eden. First, God's first dietary law. I give you all plants and seeds as food. It is for you. And be fruitful and multiply. And if Zoe have been actually proved by a lot of scientific studies that animal protein gets a few heart attacks, strokes, diabetes, and all a lot of other diseases. Think you serious that God say, I give you corpses, flesh, even if it glow up your arteries and give you heart attacks, strokes, being fruitful and multiply. See you? This philosophy don't hold stand. And in the last of the barn, cow will eat with the wolf one little sheep won't live with a lion, and a little child will lead them. And nobody wants to murder or kill on my holy mountain. The begin and the end being vegan, because veganism is only way to live without intentional harm to other living beings. I've been vegan for at least 12 years. No single disease. Well, I've no single disease get from that. My blood test be perfect. So he talks a little bit of bullshit, actually, in my opinion. And we be not on this, when we not on YouTube here on this planet to please anybody. Of course, some people do that because they're being basically the goody hunters. But I stand for something. A person that stands for nothing will fall for anything. Just be you, avocado boy. You stand for nothing. Any miserable fool that have nothing to be proud of. Try to find us a last resort. Pray in the nation where we are born. Protect all his foolish, protect all his floods. In order for his own insecurity. Or discern himself for his own insecurity. Artie Schopenhauer.
Whether you believe in God, whether you believe in the stars, whether you believe in the psychic twins like I do. We're omnivores. We eat lots. Our appendix used to be bigger, but since as we evolved, started eating more meat, animals.
Scientific work, you know that the appendix being there to store nutrients, actually.
The appendix is now useless, and it's actually considered a dangerous organ because it can go wrong, because it's just shrunk over evolution. The appendix, its role was to digest and process more plant matter, but we don't have that same capabilities, you understand? Now, I'm not saying we can't digest a salad, but I'm saying if we...
Humans exist now for something like 250 billion years. Only around something like 10,000 years since the last time, a big ice time, humans eat meat there. That's what they've been actually. And that's the reason that your entire argument is nothing more than one strongman fallacy that been based on disproved science outdated data from Old Mayan caved Stone Age time archaeology. So I can't call it now. Actually, humans eat at least for 10,000 years rice and other starchy vegetables. And actually, just like whatever, actually eat for far longer time fruits and other high sugary carbohydrate rich food like bananas, but actually have all vitamins and minerals that your body needs, with exception of vitamin B12 that actually does bacteria that live naturally in your mouth and intestines by healthy people.
We can't change back time. I remember when I was raw vegan. You guys, I feel like I'm going in circles. I remember when I was raw and everyone was just like, oh, this is how you have to be vegan. You have to only eat fruit. Even if you feel like crap, still do it because you're supposed to. Shame on you if you don't do it. And a lot of people were shamed into doing it. Whether the fact they were getting fat or sick or their hair was falling out, they were shamed into doing it because it was like this peer pressure stuff on the internet. And then I spoke to some other plant-based doctors and they're like, look, we evolved to eat cooked food. It's cooked foods support it in our DNA. We can't just turn back the clock. Thousands upon thousands of years between then and now. Like taking one animal that's evolved from that animal and putting it back on that diet, it's gonna die. It's gonna get sick. It won't absorb nutrients. But there are problems. What happened? If you look at any species throughout the world, my mind is rambling and I'm nervous. I don't even know what I'm saying. What did I just say? I don't know. I went out and I saw two doctors here where I live. Now, I don't speak Spanish. It was all translated to me. And luckily, I live someplace where it's free. I mean, yes, the consultations were free. How amazing is that? You know, in the United States, you have to call and do the insurance thing. And you have to wait 4 months for the appointment. You pay $300 just for them to bang your joints and say, your reflexes are good. Carry on, you're good. You know, whatever. The first lady, she was very against what I was doing. She goes, well, why? You're not a rabbit. You're not an ape.
Doctors get little to no dietary training in their 8 to 12 year diet, their drug company, aka medical education. So doctors being there actually not to make you better. Doctors are being actually there to make money. The health business is, the medical business is a business. It is not healthcare. It is medical care. They're being to make money. And that cannot make so much money about people that being healthy. Are you serious? Thank you that the multi-billionaire industry pharmaceutical industry get rich on a handful of people that call themselves vegan and not billions and billions of meat, dairy and egg eaters? Do the map.
You're not a primate, you're a human being. You're designed an omnivore. It's about balance. And the other doctor I saw was a male, and he was actually more open about it. He was like, you know, I think, you know, it could be very good for cleansing. Because, like, here, a lot of they call them Indians, even though they're not from India. They're just the original South American tribe people. They used a lot of herbs and...
Fortunately, about the Indian, Native American historians written laws, Native Americans eat very little meat before the Western people intruded America. Aztecs, Mayas, Hopi, and a lot of other Native American stems live on wholly and mostly only on plant foods. Unfortunately, if you use logic, the cost so much amount of land to feed people on meat dairy and eating diet and living in harmony with nature, and on top of that, yes, living in harmony with nature and eating meat dairy and eggs have the same amount of incomes as milk and fig and companion animal care. Of course, these hypocrites all want to protect their egos of their country and of their states, because they also eat this time meat, dairy and eggs, and they want better to rely and protect the community that speak the truth and speak the truth and be honest. I think one of the most problems with most of societies is that anybody live for their families, do ever what the family want them to do, don't break their invisible inbound accord and live their life moral and compassionful, instead to protect the violent rituals and traditions of their ancestors.
Every single day, basically, ate birds and did what they needed to do. Ate bugs! Oh my gosh, people here in the capital eat, like, ants. So,
and even if some groups of Native Americans eat any day meat, even if that been true, then they're do this because they're being an extremely surviving scenario, but that is no justification for continuing engaging in violent rituals that be based on bloodshed. People have done a lot of idiotic and immoral things in the past, what I do because of pure survival scenarios. For example, cannibalism. Make that it good to cannibalize? Of course not. I stop on this part, because anything what he now says, repeat and repeat anything over and over. And I hope you see this video, Avocado, and apologize for the way you have done to the plant, to the other animals where we share the planet with. And become again vegan. Only this one time truly, and not only plant-based. What's the excuse for causing the least amount of harm possible on this planet? Stop been basic, apathetic, myopic, drone, and I see you next time. Go vegan. When darkness and light become one, reality splinters away, and the true become visible.